Hey y'all, it's Jessica Ray Plays, and thank you so much for coming back to the channel for your brand new episode of the 100 Baby Man Challenge. So thank you guys so much for coming back to the 100 Baby Man Challenge. We are getting so close to Roberto being an elder in this episode, and we're actually going to go visit some grandbabies as well. Let me take you in the game real quick in a minute and let me show you something. But first, I know that I'm probably looking all over the place, and I am. I was not going to do face cam today. I was like, you know what? I'm just not feeling it. Don't really want to get on there and show my face today. I just kind of like want to be on naturel and not have any foundation or anything on. But then I decided I was going to, because I want to show you guys that you guys are beautiful just the way that you are. You don't need foundation or anything else to, you know, make yourself look good. I do have mascara on because I didn't want to feel totally naked and just overwhelmed. This is already a huge step. My hair is just living its best life. Like literally I just took it down off of its ponytail that it's been having all day, so it is like definitely got that cramped and crazy stuff going on, and I did have to put it half up because it's just a hot mess express, and y'all don't need to be seeing all that. But 2020 has been a rough year, so I feel like this is what has come out of a rough year. Just a hot mess. A rough, hot mess. So let's go on again. Let me show you something real quick. So last episode, when we checked out Roberto's current children, it said 75. If I can, I'm going to try to like go through and like insert a screenshot of like when we checked it, like right here or something or another, so that you guys can see that it was 75. So I don't know like what happened between now and then, if we've lost a kid, but I looked and there was no like passed away children or anything like that. So I don't really know what happened to that one kid or one child or adult or whatever, but I'm still gonna count it as 75 because I do feel like that one was right, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna go over 100 anyways. But just in case, if we get there and we're like at 99 on here, we know that it's truly 100 because for some reason it's not showing up as 75, but it's 75. It's not 74, it's 75. Okay, it's 75. But right now, Roberto, darling, is just going around and opening up some presents because, as you guys know, last episode, we did not get to do a lot of opening the gifts because, well, we had some issues with a lot of stuff. And he's over here just like, hey, Jessica, I cannot get to these presents, okay? It's just not happening to every single one of them. But looks like we did get some things. I don't really know what happened. What the heck is this? A wolf eel? I have never, ever seen this thing. Ooh, it looks so weird. Okay, that's kind of cool. And then we're going to actually go ahead and we're going to head off and we're going to like leave our kids just for a little bit. I definitely want to go around and see some of the grandkids because, as you guys know, Roberto is aging up actually. When is it? Tomorrow. So today is his last day as a man. And then he's going to be an adult. So let's go ahead and travel, and we're going to go see if we can't find some of our grandkids. So first child up is this little guy, and his name is Mackenzie Munch. So he is actually, looks like he's shirtless. He's actually Tristan Munch's kid. He had a baby with Summer. Okay. And then they actually just had a baby. I kind of cheated and looked on the family thing, so we're actually going to go in here and see what's up with our other kid. Okay, so where's our other kid at? Oh my, wait, what? Okay, holy crap, who are yous? There's so many kids. So maybe we're just coming here and do super efficient baby care on all of them, because I don't know which one is our grandkid. So we're just gonna come in here and give all of them some loving. Like, why not? But we can't get to this little guy because apparently they're just like blocking the whole. Oh, so that's the Scott baby. So obviously we just gave some lovings to the wrong kid. Great. So I had to enable free build so that we could move our little grandson over here so that we can officially take care of our grandkid. And oh my gosh, look how stinky he is. But obviously, I can't believe Mr. Tristan has given us two grandkids. Actually, two grandsons, I should add. So obviously, this little guy is one of them. And then we also got a child grandson as well. That's just so crazy to think that we have obviously children and even toddlers. And obviously, our kids are having kids as well. So that is Kiran Munch. So that is our grandson. So we have officially met our grandson, little baby. And then, oh, we need to actually come and meet him as well, Mr. Mackenzie Munch. Oh, he looks just so much like his dad. I'm sorry, but there's no Roberto on him at all. So obviously, we had to have a little introduction with Mr. Mackenzie, introduce herself, say, hey, I'm your grandfather. I'm your dad's dad. Probably never seen me. You're probably like 10 years old now or something like that. And here I am for the very first time. Oh, it looks like somebody passed away. He had like the Reaper sign over his head. I don't know if maybe somebody passed away or not, but kind of interesting. Just literally just sitting on a bed right next to Travis Scott, who's trying to sleep. And we're just like chatting away with our grandson. Probably talking about cars and vehicles and I don't even know what. So yeah, so here it is. There's Mackenzie and there is Kareen. Now we do have other kids as well. Obviously, you guys know that Mr. Derek Goff had some kids. Now they are not staying with them. I have no idea where these kids are because I checked in the house because he's actually living with the Goff family. So there is Dalton Chang and I have not found them. And then there is Roger Talia. So obviously, Mr. Derek Goff has been spreading his seeds everywhere because he doesn't live with them. Now, I think she does live in San Myshuno, so we could easily go and check her out as well. And then this little guy, Nico. I don't know where that one is, but we'll try to find them. And then obviously, this is Chase. He actually does live in Sulani with our ex-wife. And they had a little boy named Garrison. And then the last grandkid that we have actually from Raya Jolly. And I think she lives in San Myshuno as well. And her daughter's name is Rokio Jolly. Oh my gosh, these names are like literally killing me. So that's about it. Like I said, I don't really know what happened to our missing child. We haven't had any babies. Like, we have no babies. So I don't know if maybe somebody... I don't know what happened to our missing child. Ooh, so there's the Chang residence. Oh, there's Dalton. So she's actually not too far. So she's just like right across the street from here. And who is this little guy? See, this is like where Derek lives. He lives with Cassandra and he lives with Zoe. And there's just Jonathan. And then obviously we found Chang. So here is our granddaughter literally just out here roaming about. Not inside with her mom whatsoever. We literally just loaded into the... Oh, and he's fixing his hair. Fabulous. While your granddaughter is out here in the cold, you're going to fix your hair. Can you just introduce yourself to your grandchild, please? Who has no hair? But is this the mom? No, that's paparazzi. Okay, great. So paparazzi is coming around and be like, oh, look at Roberto finally coming around to seeing his grandkids. But looks like they actually have like a good, kind of like nice relationship with each other. And look at her. She's just like so cute, like looking up to him like, hey, grandpappy. Aw, blue kisses. I'm all that. Oh, okay, Roberto. That's not what you're supposed to be doing right now. You're supposed to be showing people that you're change men. And now you're just showing people that you're all that. Look, now you're teaching your granddaughter to say, I'm all that. Like, look at me. And I'm fixing my hair. Oh, okay. Yeah. So I think that we found Nico Landgrab's son. He's actually with this lovely lady whose last name is Randall as well. So I'm really, really hoping that this is him up here. Unfortunately, it does not have his name over it. So I'm hoping once we come up here and like do a super efficient baby care, kind of like introduce ourselves to him, that maybe, hopefully, like he'll have a little name pop up. Obviously, we're so good with kids now. We just kind of totally got this. And it is, we have found our grandson. Oh my gosh, yes. So now let's go find the next one. Yes, thank you for putting him to bed. She's like, thank you for putting him to bed. Thank you for giving him goodnight kisses. Bye. So this is the place where it literally all started. Literally just across the hall is where Roberto started his 100 baby challenge. But here's one of our granddaughters, Rokiko Jolly, and then obviously we have another little granddaughter, I think, or is it grandson? Well, grandson Mateo, who is here as well. So we're gonna see. There she is. There's Miss Jolly. We're gonna give her a friendly introduction. And here is our other grandson over here by Mateo. And I have no idea. Oh, these are our children. I was gonna say I have no idea who those guys are, but yeah, that's our kids. That we have no idea who they are. But looks like he's trying to chat with Mateo, and Mateo's just like, hey, what's up? But I'm not really kind of interested, so what's going on? What do you want? I definitely have... Oh my gosh, Roberto pulled out the autograph and was like, here, this will cheer you up. It cheers up everybody. Oh my gosh, no he didn't. But I think that's going to be the end of our baby journey. So let's see, for grandbaby wise, we did meet, I did not find this baby, Roger Talia. I did find the mom, but there was no like baby activity in her house. So I'm not really for sure where they are. And then obviously we met this little guy just now. And then we met this little cutie. We're not going to go to the Ryder household just because that's a little awkward being our ex-wife and our son and just, yeah, all that. We did get to meet these little guys because they were in one household, so that was really, really nice as well. And then obviously we just met this little bean. So not too bad. We didn't get to meet like two kids. I feel like that's not too bad at all, but I definitely feel like it is time to maybe make one more pit stop before we go home. Oh my gosh, no freaking way. So we just came over here to this, to bless, oh my gosh, the lady in Eco Lifestyle, because I wanted to have a baby with her and she is on fire. Oh my god. Can you extinguish her, please? I don't want another death. Oh my gosh. I swear, I don't know what it is with all these fires. Dude, we saved you. No freaking way. Oh my gosh, we saved her, but now she's so stinky and he wants to do like, I'm all that again. But no, no, we need to hug her. We need to, is there like a romance one? Like, where is the romance? I want to throw petals at her. See, she gave us a hug saying, oh, thank you so much for saving my life. But now we're going to throw petals at you and do these like little magic fingers and make you fall in love with us. Because guess what? We're going to be an elder tomorrow. And Roberto's like, you know what? I need to add you to my baby mama list. But first, let's attempt a mistletoe kiss. Let's see if it works. I don't think she's going to fall for it, though. Oh, okay. She did. I definitely feel like maybe, you know, getting saved probably was like, you know what? I'm just going to let you do whatever you want to do. They are actually going to go die for some thrills right now. Obviously, my man Roberto is just like taking his sweet time. Because he's like, you know what? I'm getting ready to be gramps tomorrow. I don't want to break anything. And I'm sure she's probably like, where is she? Where are we going? Oh my gosh, it's going to take Roberto forever to get down there. Oh, and the city's not even clean yet either. This is still like the nasty, gross place. Oh, Roberto, honey, are you really going to? I don't know if I would if I was you. And we're still waiting for Roberto. She's like over here, like literally waiting for Roberto. And oh my gosh, he has yet to make it across the bridge. You're going to give up and turn around, aren't you? Oh, just 5 years later. Here we go. Dive for some thrills. Oh, pull her in. Okay, wow. I have yet to see this interaction, like, in person. Interesting. Okay, so I forgot that I had Wonderful Whims installed, and I totally forgot that I had to reset all those beautiful settings again. So that was the reason why we could not get pregnant, and I realized before and I went ahead and stopped it. So now that we can, let's go ahead and finally, and hope to goodness that these two can make a baby in this dumpster. And literally that is going to be the whole shebang for his, you know, adulthood. Going out in the dumpster. I mean, why not? Make that baby a dumpster baby. What do you do? Just pat. Oh, he's a proper celebrity. Look at him. He's like, Okay. So that's how you global superstars get fame. I mean, to be fair, we was her knight in shining armor. We came over, we saved her from a fire, and oh my gosh, how long are they going to go for? Okay, surely to goodness, after all that, that she is hopefully pregnant. Let's just go ahead and take a little peek and see. Let's see, pregnancy? No, she's not. Oh my gosh. Okay, so we're going to have to do this again. Sorry, Roberto. Try for baby. All right, all right. Okay, okay. Are you pregnant? That's just the real question. Are you pregnant? We are. One male. What is up with you and males? Oh my goodness. I really was thinking about going to the Tinker family, but you know what? I think I'm going to leave the Tinker family alone and... Oh, wait, what? He's getting ready to be an elder. Wait, what? Oh, and we kicked her butt, too. Oh, my gosh. Wait, what the heck? Chat with her? And now we're going to do a kiss? Oh, my God. What is going on here? Okay, I think you need to go home. You need to plan your birthday party, okay? You can invite her to your party if you want. But for now, babes, I really do need to get you home. I mean, it's time for you just to go home. That's right. Leave. Leave. Oh gosh. Okay, so Roberto is finally home and he immediately came over here and started opening up more Christmas presents. Like, we have enough stuff in our house, but you know, I just feel like it is time to try to get these presents out of here. And we do have his birthday scheduled for 4 o'clock this afternoon. I can't wait to go ahead and do that. And I'm actually gonna have little Mr. Jackson, who is dancing. I'm gonna have him come over here and play kitchen. I think this little thing is so freaking cute. This is Cece, but oh my gosh, I wish we had something like this in The Sims. I think it's so freaking cute. I mean, look at it. He gets his little hat on, he stands on some books, and he starts making some cute food. Oh my gosh, we got crayons, we got like a gummy fish in there. Look at him, he's like even tasting it. And he's like, yuck, it tastes so bad. Or maybe that's his fart, maybe that's what he's smelling. But this is just so freaking cute. We haven't had any babies in a while. Like, there's been no baby activity. So, do we have any more babies? Oh, I'm about to make him pregnant. No, let's not do that. Okay, so we actually have 75 now. Wait, so did we have a baby? Yes, we did. Oh my gosh. Okay, finally. It took someone a little bit of while, but we got one little baby now. Deacon? I don't know. Mosley. So we got one kid. So instead of 75, we have 76 kids now. That's pretty amazing. I don't know who that one was or when we even had babies with her, but I'm sure it was sometime another. And what are you even doing, Roberto? Are you like just checking out stuff? I mean, that's totally fine. Oh, little Jackson made a thing. Don't try to eat it though. It's certainly not eatable. Oh my gosh. Look how freaking cute. See, look at this. He made this. Look how cute that is. Oh, it's like a big giant thing of Play-Doh with all kinds of stickers and glitter and probably those little styrofoam squeezy things. Oh, just so cute though. So here we are at Roberto's big elder party. So I totally feel like this is how Roberto would go out. He would totally go out in style and have a beach party and obviously have women in bikinis come to his party. I mean, that's just how Roberto would go out. I mean, why not? But obviously we did invite some of our kids. As you can see, we've got all of our little kitties here. They just look so cute. We do have some of our oldest ones as well. This is obviously Jasmine Bailey, who's here as well. So it's just really, really cute and just a fun time to have. We did invite, obviously, the Catalinas already up here. And as you can see, she's not showing at all. But I feel like Roberto would come up here and try to dance with her. I mean, why not, right? Let's see. How do we even come up here and, like, dance with her? There we go. Oh, nope. Just kidding. He's like, oh, instead of dance battle, let me just teach you a few things. Challenge. Okay, there we go. Now we're doing it. See what's happening. No, Roberto. React in disgust. No, quit, Roberto. No, dance battle. Oh my gosh, she's actually showing. Wow. Okay. So she is actually showing. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. And she's just in her first trimester. So that's crazy to me that she's actually showing. And we actually have her who's not showing at all. I wonder where the other sister is. Is this her? Oh, is she showing? No, she's not showing either. Okay. Oh, but she's doing her angry stomp though. Oh, and she's the one that actually has two females. Oh, I totally forgot about that. And she's in her first trimester as well. Okay. Oh, and here's a dance battle going on. Oh my gosh. Is he gonna win though? That's the question. What are you getting a phone call from? Bless. Oh, why is she calling you? Do you wish you looked as happy as I do? Well, you have the power. Just send me one simoleon. I mean, why not donate you one simoleon? Go ahead. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. This is a hoot. Looks like he's actually winning though. Who is this? Oh, it's a DJ. Have we had a baby with you? No, we haven't. We have not had babies with you. Is there even a place here to even do woohoos with? Probably not. Where is our person that's supposed to be coming and making us a beautiful cake? Oh my gosh, our caterer is our son. Derek Goth is our son, and he's just over here chilling. Like, I don't want to make dad a cake. I don't want him to grow old. But I'm actually gonna have, well, I was having Roberto come over here and make his own cake so that we could go ahead and do this, but he's just getting asked by tons of advice. Obviously, his kids have other opinions. They're like, no, dad, talk with us. But let's see if we can work our magic with this DJ, because obviously we have not had babies with her. And that's just how, you know, he does. He's like, you know what? I'm not an elder yet, okay? I haven't made that step yet. But obviously, my man's looking good with his six pack and his beautiful pink shorts. So obviously, he's gonna come over to her and say, hey, you wanna go make a baby in a bush? Literally, that's the only thing that is around here. And just look how freaking gorgeous this is. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. So I don't know which bush they're gonna go into and do their thing, but hopefully it's soon. I'm really hoping that our caterer, we got a mixologist who's not doing anything. We have this little lady, Princess, who is literally trying to fix it. I don't think that happened. I don't think the baby JoJo worked. I think she left us. She left us. She straight up left us. Who are you? So it turns out, I guess we should have went to just a birthday, like a restaurant, because this is not working. Or maybe we should just go on home because that was a super fail. But obviously Roberto came home and look who has showed up on our front doorstep. Obviously it is the DJ lady who has just come around. I was like, hey, sorry for ditching on you earlier, but I had something I had to go run and do, but now I'm available. You want to go do what we were talking about? Oh, it looks like Roberto got struck by lightning. Oh my gosh, I missed that. Oh baby, you got struck again. Oh my gosh, maybe you should give up on trying to woohoo one more time. Maybe you should just go ahead and age up. Oh gosh. Okay, maybe just go ahead and do the thing. Oh wait, what is going on with your eyes? I mean, my man is looking like Cyclops right now, and he's all burnt and crispy and everything else, but why not go ahead and knock it out with two birds with one stone, you know? Go ahead and make that baby and then also get clean from getting struck by lightning. I mean, why the heck not? Okay, so she is indeed pregnant. Thank goodness, but obviously that did not work. So maybe I'm just maybe have him take a regular shower. Come on, Roberto, you need to take this regular shower. You need to get cleaned up before you scare your kids. There's an emergency. I need to go now. Okay, that's so awkward. Oh my gosh, yes. So we can actually use this cake right here. It's actually got birthday candles on it and everything. And all we gotta do is just come down here and blow it. And oh my gosh, my man's got a mask on. Okay, blow out the candles. Oh my gosh, this is it. This is it. This is it. And it's New Year's Eve now. What the crap? This is just crazy. I mean, happy birthday. Oh my gosh, you're still looking really, really rough. But oh my oh my gosh. Seniority, wrinkled bellies, frosty locks, and interval naps await. Party like the Reaper's not around the corner. Oh my gosh. And we got birthday gifts from all of our kids. Wow. That's a lot of gifts. Oh, the gifts are still coming. Just like Roberto. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Can I get rid of a Cyclops? Is there a way like I can reset him? Oh my gosh. There we go. At least his eyes are looking better now. I don't know how to get rid of this craziness. Okay, my man's got some glowing eyes. I have no idea what is going on here. Hypercharged from being struck by lightning repeatedly. Roberto is overcharged with electric energy. The power of the storm lies at his fingertips. Oh my gosh. He's got amazing skin though. I mean, why not? Oh, baby doll. Okay, but before we do wrap this up, I do want to take him into cast and kind of give him a grandpa makeover. I just can't believe this time has finally happened where he is now an elder. And obviously having kids now is going to be so, so rough because obviously I feel like every time that we try to have babies, even if we have to like do it multiple times, which he does have to do it multiple times. It seems like, especially here lately, he's going to be, he's going to have to be a one-hit wonder because if he has to be like three or two, my man's going to die. And I know that's the way that he wants to go out, but I don't want him to go out that way just yet, okay? Like, he needs to pop out these kids. But let's go in to cast and look what my man looks like. Oh my gosh, look at my man. Okay, let me do this. Okay, there we go. So this is what my man Roberto looks like as an elder. I bet he looks so weird if I took off his skin detail. Oh, babes. Oh, baby. Yeah, that's bad. I wonder if there's something that we can do like just to kind of give him like a little bit of a skin detail. Like I want his wrinkles and stuff to come through. I feel like this is like a pretty good one. I definitely don't think I'm gonna have him have a beard anymore. I think he would have like a clean shave now. Maybe we can do some like just, I don't know. I've never seen him without like a beard. Or maybe we just go like full kind of crazy man. And maybe we should do gray. Oh, and I need to turn my baby gray now. Oh my gosh, he's gray. Oh, babes. Oh, I never would expect the day. And I think it is time to get rid of the earrings, unfortunately. Oh gosh. Okay, so this is his everyday. Now, he is in Solani, and I do have a surprise because I definitely feel like he is going to retire in Solani. He's like, you know what? I don't want to go back to San Myncuno. I want to stay in Solani and I want to live my days here because I think it's so much more fun for him. He gets to do kind of like whatever he wants to do. And obviously there's an ocean nearby. There's just a lot more fun stuff for him to get into. Now, obviously trying to find him some like grandpa clothes are definitely going to be a little bit more difficult, especially for his hot weather wear, because I don't really have that much like grandpa, I don't have like that much like t-shirt stuff. Oh gosh. So I kind of feel like my man would wear something kind of like this, like maybe he's just like wearing some blue jeans now and kind of like just this like open shirt because he can't get the buttons, you know, buttoned anymore. Definitely looks old. Oh my gosh. And he got rid of his like little mustache. Now he's trying to be, you know, all prim and proper. Oh my lordy day. And obviously I'll come back in here and like change up the rest of them, but oh my gosh, my babes, he's old. Wow, this feels like so crazy because it's taken us a year to get here. This is like the second series or maybe third series I started when I first started my YouTube adventure. So just to have him be this old and gray, it looks just super, super weird. But I'm just so glad that it's here. I'm so glad that it's literally about to come to a head. We are once we hit 100 babies, we are going to keep continuing on. We're not going to slow down at all. We're literally going to follow him until he passes away. I just feel like that's a good way to say goodbye to him in the series. But, I mean, literally, if we look really quickly, like, how much longer does he have until he ages up? I don't even know, like, what it is. Oh, it doesn't say. It just says number of days lived. He's 92 years old. Wow. Okay. Well, we know it's not in the next 2 weeks, so that's kind of nice to know that he has at least 2 weeks to live, and maybe, I bet, maybe he'll probably pass away in maybe summer or maybe the first week of fall. I'm not really for sure how long they have when you're playing this, but I'm just having a ball with it so far. I hope you guys are still liking this series. We are getting so stinking close. Let's check one last time just to make sure that no other babies, like, popped in just in that little bit of time. So, we have 75, oh wait, days left? 11?
Shut up.
No way. He does not have 11 days left. There's no way. There's no way. You gotta be joking me, right? There's no way he's got 11 days left. I mean, pregnancy takes 3 days away. Oh my gosh. So, next episode, he's just going to have to go out there and start hunching and start making babies and just going crazy because we have to have 25 more kids. Oh my God, we're going to fail this. We're not going to make it. We're going to fail. We do have 75 kids, but remember, we do add one more because for some reason it went missing. So, we are up to 76 kids right now. That is insane. Like, I feel like we would have had, like, more kids by now. So, I definitely feel like since we only have 11 days now, once we do the deed and we get them knocked up, we need to immediately go in and do them as showing or first trimester or something because we're going to have to pick up the pace a little bit because even when you do take a pregnancy test, it shows you, like, you know, you're showing or something. So, us not doing that, I think it kind of makes it a little bit longer. So we're going to have to start like trying to pick up the pace a little bit because obviously he has kids, but I just don't want him to fail because he's literally going to pass away and not have kids. So 76 kids is not too bad, but hopefully we'll get there before this ends. But as always, I love you all so much. And thank you so much for your continued support on this series. I love you all and I will see you guys on my next video. And don't forget, I do post videos on Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. And remember, Sunday is a bonus day if something needs to be caught up or I'm slacking that week. I use that day as like an extra day to get caught up. And if you are new to the channel, make sure you do hit that subscribe button because it does just help our little village to grow. And remember to leave me comments down below because remember, that is where you do shine. And I love you all so much and I'll see you next time. Bye guys. Mwah. Bye.